Because there's a case, I think, pending. I'd like to ask now the NBI if the case has already been filed against Empire 999 Incorporators or Mr. Willie Ong. If not, can the Anti-Money Laundering Council immediately freeze assets of the Mr. Willie Ong and Empire 999 Incorporators? Is that possible?
Mr. Chair, just to put a context on the question, money laundering is a predicate offense, is a derivative offense.
So maybe kayo ang ahensya na dapat po mag-validate ito. I will share with you this information so that you will also have a guide as to paano nyo pong masusundan ito. Yes. Yes, Attorney.
Yes, Mr. Chair, that's the one that we're going to request to for the committee to please provide us a copy. Although, sir, I believe in furtherance of the AMLAC investigation, we have shared for intelligence purpose with our counterpart from NBI. For intelligence purpose, financial intelligence report from the AMLC.
Okay, question lang. No? This information has not yet been validated. No? Because there's a case, I think, pending. I'd like to ask now the NBI if the case has already been filed against Empire 999 Incorporators or Mr. Willie Ong. If not, can the Anti-Money Laundering Council immediately freeze assets of the Mr. Willie Ong and Empire 999 Incorporators? Is that possible?
Mr. Chair, just to put a context on the question, money laundering is a predicate offense, is a derivative offense, and there must be a predicate offense. In this case, the violation of RA number 9165. Although there's a provision, Mr. Chair, in the RA 9160 that freezing is non-conviction based, we must prove that there is a probable cause that a certain funds or property is in any way related to unlawful activity.
Like in this case, Empire 999 owns the warehouse where the Shabu was discovered, was delivered. Isn't that already a predicate crime?
That is a predicate crime, Mr. Chair. That's why on the part of the AMLAC, we request at least that a copy that the case has already been filed. And we understand that the NBI is already working on it, Mr. Chair.
Okay, thank you, Attorney. Now, let me ask the NBI. NBI, meron na bang kasong na i-file against Empire 999 or Mr. Willie Ong and the incorporators of Empire 999?
Not yet, Mr. Chairman.
Why is that so? This has been, ano ba to? Ilang months na to? The last hearing we had, we asked the NBI to expedite the filing of cases kasi nagkakaroon na ng bentahan ng properties eh. And we want to prevent that from happening. And why haven't NBI filed the case yet?
Mr. Chairman, we complied with the DC number 20 of the DOJ.
Which requires of conviction.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. So we're just complying now with some instructions provided by the NPS, mainly to secure a warrant for the disclosure of computer data.
Pero, Attorney Galicia, last year pa ito, you have all the, perhaps you have all the proof to initiate the filing of a case.
As you discovered, uncovered, Mr. Chairman, that this is not a simple case. No? This is a complex case which involves a lot of agency.
And we... yung case sa drugs muna, kasi yun yung original eh. Diba? Are you telling us that the NBI is now contemplating on filing several charges on the basis of several crimes committed by Empire 999.
Well, Mr. Chairman, just like the nationality of the Mr. Willie Ong, we have to establish. Until now, because of the document provided by PSA that he's a Filipino citizen. Now, the only way for us to be able to prove that he's a Chinese national is for us to go to the Chinese embassy, which is taking so much time, Mr. Chairman. We cannot just say that he's a Chinese without proof, Mr. Chairman. So we're having a difficulty of securing those documents.
Chairman, can we interject?
Okay, yes, Congressman Paduano.
Yung case ba ni Willie Ong is different from Eddie Young with regards to travel records?
No, Your
Honor. Oh, so Willie Ong is using a Chinese passport?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, but because of the different name that was used by Willie Ong, he's using a Chinese passport and a Filipino.
So Willie Ong is using a different name with a Chinese passport.
Tama yes, pa? Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Now, the same is true with Eddie Young. Eddie Young has a Filipino passport in the name of Eddie Young, but he's using a Chinese passport going out of the country and going into the country. It's the same, di ba?
Yes, so, Mr. Chairman.
So ako, Mr. Chairman, BID na lang po mag-certify para makagalaw na to. Kasi just like what we have done. Oh, for example, ngayon, Mr. Chairman, tingnan mo, Eddie Young is fugitive in the house because he was contempted. He has a detention order. And until now, nowhere to be found. Well, in fact, yan pa yung itatanong ko mamaya sa mga agencies. Willie Ong now, as of now, hindi rin makita. Ang travel record niya, he's using a Chinese passport with a different name. Now, but it was with regards to Eddie Young, it was confirmed, Mr. Chairman, kasi yung picture niya, itsura niya, pati date of birth is the same. And that confirms that Eddie Young is a Chinese citizen. So ako, Mr. Chairman, hindi pa ba nagawa ng BID at saka ng NBI yung process na ginawa natin kay Eddie Young? Yes, BID.
Mr. Chair,
yes,
from
sir.
The end of the Bureau of Immigration, we cannot certify if there is if an individual is one and the same person. We only base our findings on the record that we have. We can provide whatever agency that is interested a copy of the passport, assuming that they did use it, and their travel records. But we cannot certify. We are not authorized to certify. And we do not have the power to certify that they are indeed one and the same person, Your Honor.
Pero you can provide this committee the picture of Willie Ong with us. May Filipino passport ba siya?
Pero it would be the DFA to answer. We leave it to the DFA.
May Filipino passport ba si Willie Ong?
Okay, before you answer that, DFA, Congressman Paduano, since wala naman po tayo may tatanong ngayon dito sa ating mga Chinese nationals nandito, so maybe we can ask them to leave and go back to the BID detention center. I believe they're detained in the BID detention center, no?
Yes, Mr. Chen.
And also Attorney Suwa is asking to be excused since we don't have any questions relative to the Yatai Industrial. We expect you in the next scheduled hearings to attend.
Yes, sure.
Together with your clients,
yes, sure.
Attorney. So thank you for attending in this committee hearing. Ngayon, Congressman Paduano is asking the DFA kung meron bang Filipino passport si Mr. Willie Ong. DFA?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Yes, Your Honor, meron po siyang Filipino
passport. May travel record.
That record is available with BI, Your Honor.
When was the date issued to Willie Ong?
The last passport of Willie Ong, Your Honor, was issued on 17 July 2019, Your Honor.
2019? Yes, so 2010 to 29 pa mag-expire?
Yes, Your Honor.
BID, yung Willie Ong that was issued by DFA with regards to a Filipino passport, may travel record ba yun?
Mr. Chair, based on the travel database of the Bureau of Immigration, we do not have any entry of one Willie Ong with the who was born on May 29, 1977. No travel record, Your Honor.
DFA, yung record with regards to the Willie Ong is the same, yung date of birth.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, the same case with Eddie Young, Mr. Chairman. Eddie Young has a Filipino passport in the name of Eddie Young, but he is using a Chinese passport and a Chinese name. So, we only confirmed that indeed that was Eddie Young because he attended in the second hearing, then nawala. At ito naman, sa BID, chinek natin, may picture, Eddie Young and a certain Kai Jai Jing
Ming.
Jai Jing. And nakalimutan ko yung pangalan ni Eddie Young.
Young Jai Jing and...
is one and the same. That is why, ito conclusion to ng committee. Of course, you cannot certify, no? But ang sinasabi ko lang po, pictures, date of birth, and travel records will confirm. Now, BID, may picture na kayo ni Willie Ong, di ba?
Your Honor, we do not have any picture of the Philippine passport of Willie Ong because he did not use it to travel.
Now,
but...
now you should have secured that to DFA. Eh, yun naman ang pinag-usapan natin, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor. We're working closely with DFA and we found out that a Chinese individual by the name of Kai Kiming, who has the birthday of, who was born on 24 July 1977, looks strikingly similar to Willie Ong with the birthday of May 29, 1977.
Oh, yun na po, Mr. Chairman. Ano na tayo doon? Mr. Chairman, of course, legally, ipoprocess yan, but with regards to this representation of this committee, established na yon. Just like with Eddie Young. That's why, nasa gobyerno na ngayon, agencies. Ay, hindi nasa committee dito. But of course, wag na natin tayo yung lumabas pa yung committee report. We're running out of time. Kasi pag ganyan, of course, nagtatago ngayon. Ang next judge is, of course, NBI was ordered in the previous hearing.
PNP.
To look for Willie Ong. Because may kahit lang doon sa contempt order, and detention order for Eddie Young and Willie Ong. Kahit na wag na natin munang pagbabatayan yung question about the identities for, well indeed, if he's a Filipino or Chinese citizen. Yung question lang po nung pagdala dito as part of the contempt order dun sa mga agencies concerned. Now, but of course, habulin talaga natin ang properties sa ngayon. And sabi ko na nga, it's the LRA na ngayon. Tsaka the OSG. Diba? So I hope, if you cannot produce Willie Ong and Eddie Young, may problema tayo dyan.